culture influences our behavior. It affects the way we see the world, it affects the way we behave in particular circumstances, and it affects the way we perceive the behavior of other people around us. Take, for example, employee motivation. Most Germans will come from individualist cultures, and as such, they appreciate being referred to by name in a public recognition of effort. Most Chinese people, on the other hand, will come from a culture where the group is more important than the individual. And in these circumstances, it's better to focus on the group or the team rather than the individual. Referring to individuals specifically can cause embarrassment and can result in the opposite effect from that which you intend. This is a small example of how culture can affect our daily business interactions. I'm at the St. George Palace in Genoa, where Marco Polo was imprisoned in 1298 and where he dictated his famous book, The Travels, to a fellow inmate. He describes his fascination of traveling through China, a country with a culture so very different from the one that he was used to. Of course, since then, many things have changed, but a few things have stayed the same. We still struggle to understand cultures different from our own. Today, almost every company is made up of people from different cultures. It's one of the characteristics of globalization. But therefore, it's all the more important that we take time to understand more about what culture is. We need to understand how we absorb it and what effect it has, not only on us, but on those around us. The advantages of making the effort to become more interculturally aware are that leaders will be able to leverage their cultural diversity. They will grow their business faster than those who remain culturally blind. Their businesses will be more profitable, and they will lead their business at a lower risk.